Ladies and gentlemen, please take your seats. The show is about to begin. Before it does, two public announcements. Firstly, out of consideration for your fellow patrons, please turn off your cell phones. And secondly, if you're one of those "I love Pink Floyd, but I can't stand Roger's politics" people, you might do well to fuck off to the bar.
It's the truth. We meant to change a nation, and instead, we changed a world.
Squeeze of shit, you put on a pose, you wear the right glasses.
The big opening meeting, we all got together, and all of a sudden, just for a moment, I saw that everyone was just sitting there looking at me. And then one of them broke the silence. "Tell us about the American miracle," he said. "Hey, bartender, over here. Two more shots and two more beers. Sir, turn up the TV sound. The war started on the ground." Just love those laser guided bombs. They're really great for writing bombs. You hit the target, win the game from balls 3,000 miles away. 3,000 miles away.
See, there's a bar behind me here on top of the grand piano. The bar is somewhere where you can go in the evening and you can meet your friends and maybe even meet strangers, and you can have a drink or not have a drink, but it's somewhere where you can talk to people and where you can exchange opinions and ideas and even love with others. Okay, so this is our bar here, and it has got bottles of colourless liquid that might or might not be agua on it. More of that later. But for the purposes of this evening here, everybody in this stadium is in the bar with me and with all of my band. So we're all here together and we can communicate with one another. I think I might get on with it. You know, when the last couple of gigs were in Argentina, and I thought they were friends of mine. Like the people of Chile are friends of mine. But they wouldn't let me stay in any of the hotels, which is weird. Don't you think so? And the reason was because we believe different things, them and me, okay? I'm just going to say this, I'll say it very quickly. I know you know this, but I'm going to say it anyway. I believe in equal human rights for all my brothers and sisters all over the world, irrespective of their ethnicity or their religion or their nationality. And that, of course, includes our brothers and sisters in Palestine. Actually, now I have to tell you one other thing about this bit of the bar. It has a verse in it, specifically, that I wrote for people in Arizona who worked for one of the biggest armaments corporations in the world. It's called Raytheon, and they do nothing but build stuff to kill brown people in foreign countries. Okay, so there's a mention of them in this song. Anyway, again, I'm sorry to shout, but thank you so much for coming and sharing your love in the bar. Drift back through the mists of time to an earlier age when I was playing my rock and roll in a different band.
Thank you. tell the truth. Karma calls to your ring. Thank you.
Thank you. Oh!
I would have sired many sons, and I would not have suffered the wrongs to kill even one of them. If I thank you. the company of friends, baking bread and mended nets.
Well, because it's true that I'm stuck.
don't have enough like you to differentiate between the pain that other people feel. Well, for instance, cutting leaves or crawling across window sills in search of open treacle tins. So like, yes, are we just dumb? Is that why we don't feel the sea?
Oh, no, it's just numb now. We have the TV.
drunk at the time?
Yeah.
Shock,
shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock, shock,
Reception has meant to me and all my musicians here on stage tonight. You've been wonderful. Thank you so much. We are going to play a couple more songs. Dos Más. Okay, the first one that we're going to do, I don't know why I'm laughing. I do, I'm laughing because I'm very happy to be here with you. Wonderful gente in Santiago. The first song that we're going to do now is from the very last record that I ever made with Pink Floyd. That record was called The Final Cut, and it was in 1982. And this is the last song off the last record I made, and it's called Two Suns in the Sunset, okay, which some of you will know. It's not all that well known. It's an appropriate song for the moment. Because it's about the Third World War. And I don't want to be gloomy, but we are very close to the Third World War. If we don't get our leaders to call one, particularly Mr. Biden and Mr. Putin, and say, what is this nonsense in Ukraine? Let's stop killing Ukrainians now and make peace, please, because it's very dangerous. Not just for them. One can't imagine, and, you know, our attention shifts from one part of the world to another. But wouldn't it be a good thing if we could stop killing one another? Which brings me back to what I was saying before the bar. If we all respected Paris 1948, the Universal Declaration of Human Rights, that would be the end of war forever, everywhere in the world. So that would be a good thing. Anyway, I'm not going to make any more speeches. This song is about a bloke who's driving home one night and the Third World War. So he doesn't get home to see his wife and children. But notwithstanding that, I hope you enjoy it. It starts off with a sound effect, and the sound effect is the Doomsday Clock, which was a device that some atomic scientists invented back in 1947 to warn us that the clock is ticking, and if it ever strikes midnight, we're all dead. All right, so I'll stop. I'll get back to the smiley face, because it has been a huge pleasure to be here with you tonight. So thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Here we go. Thank you. obviously I love you too, otherwise I wouldn't be here. All right, we're back at the bar. So, in a minute, when my friend Jonathan has finished pouring out this, what we would really like to do now is to invite you all up on stage, all of you. But it's not big enough, you know, up here around this piano. So we're going to try and do the next best thing, which is we're going to drink your health, all of you, every one of you here in this stadium. Come on, men. As soon as you've got off. And ladies. Amanda, Shane, come on. Look at these beautiful women. We're waiting for the men, but they don't know. Raise up glasses. I nearly said I'm the only one with a mic, but Shanae and Amanda have mics too, so we'll do the word cheers together, all right, in a minute. Come on, Jonathan. Come on. Raise your glasses to these lovely, lovely, lovely people. Ready? 3, 2, 1. Cheers! That is not agua. It's delicious. It's actually mezcal. It's from Mexico, from north of the border. Anyway, cheers to you all. You've been so lovely with us tonight. We're going to do one more song, and have a better bar. Thank you. I have to mention three names before we do this second bit of the bar. The first name is Bob Dylan. Yeah. Back in 1966, Bob Dylan made a great album called Blonde on Blonde. And the fourth side, it was a double vinyl album. The fourth side was a beautiful ballad called Sad-Eyed Lady of the Lowlands. And when I was writing this during COVID, my song here about the bar, the lyric from Sad-Eyed Lady popped into my head, so I borrowed it. I stole it. I plagiarized it, okay. So if any of you run into Bob anywhere in the world in the next year or two or whenever, could you say to him, Bob, Roger says thank you very much. All right, because I do. Thank you, Bob Dylan. I only stole six words. Sad, eyed, lady, big, brass, bed. That was it. Six words. All right, so that was it. The second person that I want to mention is the sad eyed lady in question in the song, because she's my wife, Camila, and I love her dearly. And she is the rock upon whom I lean. And she's not always. Yeah, that's it. She's not here tonight, so we can unembarrassedly give her a round of applause. Yeah. I'm a lucky man. But what was I going to say? Yeah, she's not always sad-eyed, but she is sad-eyed sometimes because she has a big heart and she has a great capacity for empathy. So she has been pretty sad lately, thinking about all those families in Gaza being bombed mercilessly every day, up until today when they've taken a little bit of a break. So Camila, I love you, babe. Thank you for all of that. And the third name is my big brother, John. I have a big brother, or I had a big brother. He died last year. But in the song, we're very, very young. My big brother's about that big. There's a bloke with a serious case of the whistles. Oh look, there's people with lights. Whoa! I don't know why they've got lights on. Good for you. I hope that's for our brothers and sisters in Gaza. Because that would be a good thing. Wouldn't it be a good thing if Chile is one of the 149 states that is a signatory to the Genocide Convention. So Mr. Burridge, your president, he could be the one who leads the way and introduces the genocide convention to what's going on in the Holy Land now. Thank you for reminding me, all you up there. Where was I? My big brother John, okay, who died last year, but he is in his song. So this is for Bob Dylan, my wife, Camila, and my big brother, John. You are my sad eye lady. Come lay across my big brass bed. Maybe it is we who have been chosen, you and me, to point out this don't make no fucking sense. How many cannibals must fire up their own winding ethno. How many children tugging on? How many mother sleeps? Say, look, mama, the man ain't got no fucking clothes. Before I was born, my brother used to sit on daddy's lap when he was home on leave. Daddy'd smoke a cigarette, and sometimes as a jest, he'd blow smoke rings up my big brother's sleeve. Oh, fire, daddy. Mercifully spare the memories that they share. Cause I was only 5 months old when daddy died. I'm gonna call up a friend in Australia and order in some bush tucker snacks and dance with you to the didgeridoo and listen while you sing all the maps. tell me, how was life before the dumps?
Together in band.